Kieran here, the founder of Funda. Hello to all our children, parents, home educators, and schools joining in on this live lockdown learning lesson. We're going to get active. We're going to learn. We're going to have lots of fun. The Funda way. What is the Funda way? We learn new skills. We get active. We have fun together, alone, and with your parents. I hope that you find this lesson fun. We've got lots of games, activities, and Funda treats to give away. So, have you got your downloadable, printable resources and lesson plan that myself and my team has created just for you? I'm going to start this lesson. Say hello, comment below. Say hello, hello. Parents, press the love hearts, press the thumbs. Share with another parent who needs help right now to empower your child to learn, grow, improve their confidence, resilience, attitude, and to become the best they can be, unlocking their full potential. I'm Kieran, the founder of Funda, and in this lesson, we're going to learn lots and lots of activities and develop skills, improve health, well-being, and fitness. The first game, we've got a warm-up, main activities, and a cool-down, and they're all linked to the curriculum, just like you do at school. So if you're missing PE, if you're missing getting active, then let's have some fun. Treasure balance is the first activity. I'm going to give you a couple of seconds. Don't go yet. Wait until I blow my whistle. Don't go yet. You've got to run around your home and collect as many toys or equipment or cushions, pillows, toilet roll, as many objects as you can that's safe from around your home. Get as many as you can. I want you parents to take a picture of all the activities, all the obstacles, all the objects that your child has collected and post it to our page. On your marks, get set, go. Collect as many resources as you can. Go, go, go. Great, you've done it. So you're with me. I've just rushed around my Funda head office and collected lots and lots and lots of objects. Do you want to see them? I'll put my lesson plan down. Put your glasses on and look down. Look down. Here's all my objects. I've got them all here on the floor. Hope you can see all my objects and my lesson plan ready to get started. And I want you to try and balance as many of these objects as you can on your body, anywhere you want. Who can balance the most objects on your body? How fun is this? Are you ready? Pick up all your objects. So I'm going to give you a demo. I'm going to show you. So I've got Freddy the Frog can go on my head. Okay. And then I'm going to get some more objects. So Freddy the Frog can go on my head. Beanbag on one shoulder, beanbag on the other shoulder. Oh, I'm going to put some more beanbags. I'm going to put a beanbag on my hand. Oh, what else can we do? What else can we do? We could put a beanbag on our knee as well. So if you lift your knee up and stand like an ostrich, balancing on one foot. Oh, oh. So if I can do all them, I'm going to get some more. Watch Coach Kieran. I'm going to get some more. Okay, so I'm going to put Freddy the Frog on my head. I'm going to put some on my shoulder. Come on, you can do it now. Let's go. I'm going to put some more on my shoulder. I'm going to hold my pirate hook like this. Oh, it's really hard. I'm going to balance some on my hands. There, look at that. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 on my knee, 5 on my shoulder, 6 on my shoulder, 7 on my head. So we've counted to 7. Well done. Okay? 7. Who can beat 7? On your marks, get set, go, beat 7. Go, go, go. awesome. You're back. How many did you balance on your body? How many objects did you manage to balance on your body? Comment below. This is a cool warm-up, would you agree? This time, let's go. I'm going to make it harder. And what you've got to do, you've got to stand and balance as many objects as you can on your head. See if you can beat my score. So count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need more. I've run out. 6. I'm sure I could fit something else on my head. 6. 7. 7. Can you beat 7? Can you balance 7 on your head? Ready, steady, go, 7. You're finding it easy. I know you're finding that so easy. I want you to see if you can walk around the room. So you've got all your objects balancing on your head, and I want to see, watch me, if you can walk around the room. Look, hold your hands out for balance. Oh, I'm walking around the room, and I'm going to walk faster, and I'm going to start to run. I'm going to start to run. I'm going to start to run fast. And if you drop them, up, up, oh, you've got to do 5 star jumps. 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. We're going to go again. On your head. Objects on your head. Move faster. Move faster. Oh, I've dropped them again. So 5 star jumps. 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. Excellent. Well done. Let's move on, shall we? That was our warm-up game. How fun was that? Now we're going to move forward and we're going to play Frozen Foxes and Tails. Frozen Foxes and Tails. Can you steal the tail whilst frozen? So you might need a volunteer for this one. You might need a partner, okay? So you might need somebody to come out. And then it says, go and find 2 objects that can be placed down to put inside of your pants. So watch me. I'm going to find 2 objects. So 1, you can use a tea towel. You can use tissue roll. You can use ribbons, anything, a t-shirt, some old sweaty socks from your parents. Poo. Or your dad's underpants. Or your mum's knickers. But make sure that you tuck them in and create a tail like a fox. So watch this. So watch this, either side. So we're going to create a tail like a fox. There you go. A nice tail. There's my tails. 2 tails. Okay. And then, here goes. You stand facing your partner. So I'm going to face you. Because if you're alone at home and your parents not with you, or your mum and dad or grandma or your bubble isn't around and you're watching this on your own right now at home, that's okay. You can play against me and we'll just pretend. But basically, you stand with your partner because that's what it says. And you can try these lessons afterwards on your own as well. So you stand facing your partner and then you see if you can steal their tail whilst frozen. To ensure they don't steal yours, make sure you're turning your hips away from your partner. So if you're standing each other, your partner's got to try and grab your tail, grab it from you, and you've got to dodge them, okay? So you've got to dodge up, got to dodge them and make sure. So if you're facing each other, putting your hands out like this, and wait till I say go. You should have your tails in, your fox's tails in by now, okay? You should have your fox's tails in. I'll go a bit further back so you can see. You should have your fox's tails in, hands out, ready. See who can grab each other's tail and dodge them. You can't turn the back. You've got to stay facing each other and grab the tails. Are you ready? This is going to be fun. Go, grab your partner's tails. Go, go, go. And if you're pretending against me, you've got to try and get me and I'll try and get you. So we've got to reach out and grab. And I'm going to dodge. Whoa, 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 whoa. Dodge. Whoa. And you've got to try and grab the tails like this. Grab, 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 grab. Faster, faster. And if you fail or if you can't do that, you've got to jump on your parent and squeeze them and then take it from them and shout, I got it. Okay, good. So that's a fun little game called Foxes and Tails that you can play at home with your parents or in your bubble at school. Cool game. The next game in our main activity is called Active Statues. Okay, so these active statues, we're going to be put some music on. We're going to put some music on, some really good music. I've got some really good taste of music. Okay, we're going to get funky, we're going to dance, we're going to move our bodies around the front room and have a party, because that's what gets us in a good mood. We move our bodies, we move our energy in our bodies, and that makes us all positive and happy and healthy. So you've got to keep moving, guys. Okay, and then once the music stops, okay, let me see. So dance around the music, shout out a movement. So once the music stops, I'm going to shout out a movement and you have to do a movement. So watch. Let's have a practice. Put your glasses on and watch Coach Kieran, okay? So I'm going to play some music in a minute. So if the music plays, okay, we're going to dance around. We're going to party, okay? We're going to make sure that we can move our bodies, shake them, dance them, okay? You can do some really good dancing, all right? Really good dancing around the front room. And when the music stops, I'm going to shout a movement to do. So it could be jumping, and we all jump. And we keep jumping until the music starts again. It could be star jumps. It could be any movement. You just copy off me when the music stops. Are you ready? I'm going to play the music, and I want you to get crazy around your living room, space, front room, or at home. Wherever you are right now, I want you to dance around and shake your bodies like nobody else is watching. Are you ready to get funky? Are you ready to dance? Are you ready to go for it? Ready? Let me find my music. Are you ready? Steady. Go!
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, what?
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, what? It's Friday again, it's Saturday, Sunday, hey! Hey!
Up, stop. Ready? Star jumps. Everybody do star jumps really fast. Fast, fast, fast. Star jumps, clap. Clap. Star jumps, clap. 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 Good. That was just a practice. Do you get the idea? Let's go again. Let's go faster. Ready? Go!
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, what?
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, what? It's Friday again, it's Saturday, Sunday, hey! 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 Hey!
Stop! Have we got some good dancers, parents? Are we moving our bodies? This time, I want you to run on the spot really fast. Come on, run fast, fast, fast. fast, 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 fast. God, this time, what movement when we're dancing around the room can we do? What exercise can we do? What movement can we do around your front room? How can we move our bodies? Can we move like a tiger? Rah! Can we move like a snake? Can you move your bodies like an animal while dancing to the music as fast as you can? The fastest person who takes part the most will get the chance to win one of my Funda medals. I hope you're taking part. So you'll get the chance to win one of our Funda medals. And we'll also send you some stickers and certificates. Our children have got them coming on their way and we can't wait to see your pictures. So the music's going to start. Are you ready? Go!
Get off my yard, you!
Wind the bobbin up. Come on, wind the bobbin up. Wind the bobbin up. Right, let's give you some shout outs. Who have we got live? Let me see. Hi, Clint Davis. Hi, Lily May. Who else have we got? Let me see on our comments. Let me see who we've got. Let me see. We've got Eileen Lafferty, my auntie. Hello, Anna. Anna's taking part. Well done, Anna. Clint Davis, big shout out. Woo woo. Well done, Lily May. Keep turning up. Keep turning up, guys. Lily May got 5. Good, Lily May. Keep trying hard. Keep taking part in these Funda active lessons that will help you grow and be the best you can be during lockdown. Okay, the last game I'm going to show you is a TV remote game. Okay, the TV remote game. So I'm going to get my TV remote. Okay, and I want your parents to get a TV remote. Get your TV remote and then come back and say, I'm ready, Coach Kieran. Ready? Get your TV remote. Go, go, go. Yes, you've got the TV remote. And if your grandma's watching TV, if your mummy's watching TV, I want you to turn the TV off. Pew! And I want you to take out the batteries. Take out the batteries of this TV for the next half hour and take part in this lesson after I've gone as well. Turn off your mobile devices and get active. So with your remote, I want you to think about all the different buttons that your remote says or indicates. So for example, if I press play, we walk around the room, we move around the room. If I press stop, we freeze and we stay very still. If I press rewind, we go backwards. If I press forwards, we go forwards. Okay, and let me see, I've got a button on my remote that says turn around. It's got some arrows on. Don't know if you can see my remote. It says turn around. Can you see that button right there? Turn around. Okay. Or you could have red for a traffic light. Red means stop. Green means go. Yellow means run on the spot. Use your imagination. But for now, we're going to use my remote. I'm going to choose forwards, fast forward, to move forward, backwards, to move backwards, turn around, to turn around, really fast, okay, And then volume up. I want you to shout Funda, 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 Funda really loud. All right? Ready? Let's have a practice. Ready? Fast forward. Backwards. Forwards. Backwards. Forwards. Rewind. Fast forward. Turn around. Turn around. Turn around. And then the volume up. Funda, Funda, Funda. Good. Ready. Are you ready to go really fast? Are you ready? So you can give your parents the remote. You can use the remote and pretend and give yourself your own actions. And after I've gone, what other movements can you come up with? Okay, so here we go. And if I go channel up, we jump. Channel down, we're down. Channel up, channel down. Channel up, channel down. Okay, let's go. Ready, backwards. Fast forwards. Backwards. Turn around. Turn around. Faster, 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 faster. Turn around. Stop. Stay very still. Don't move. Keep still. I can see you moving. Keep very still. Don't you move. Volume down. Crouch down really low. Volume up. Reach up really high. Volume down. Touch your toes. Volume up. And stop. That was a fun game. Excellent. Okay. After this lesson, I want you to complete my goals activity. And it's very easy, my goal. Why I want to achieve this goal. First, I will do this, then this, and finally this. My obstacles. So what things might get in your way from stop you from achieving that goal? What actions will you take to overcome them? Then I will do what? If, then I will, and when will you achieve this by? Because if your goals don't have a date or a time committed to them, they're just a dream. Okay, so make sure you set your goals, guys. Send me your pictures of your work coming in. And I'm going to finish today with one of my Funda stories. Are you ready? I want you to quickly stand in the space, put your hands together like this, and relax, okay? I'll be ready when you are. Ready? Stand in a space. Go. Right, guys, before I start my story, Funda's trip to the seaside. Who's ever been to the seaside? Have you got any questions? Would you like to get anything off your chest? Have you enjoyed this lesson so far? Would you like more? If you do, comment below. Here goes. Let me see who I've got on live. Craig, we're ready. Well done, Craig Cox. We're ready. Okay, let's start with Funda's trip to the seaside. So Funda has lots of characters who like to move. Funda likes to jump. Fundette likes to shake. Shake her pom-poms. Can you shake? Shake. Fundude likes to kick. So can you kick like this? Can you kick? And kick your legs up high. Come on, everybody. Kick. 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 Good, awesome. And if you add ing to each of these orange words, jump ing, kick ing, spin ing, shake ing, they're all doing words, which means we move our bodies and get active, okay? So that's really, really important throughout this story. Are you ready to go on a journey with me? Funda and his friends are walking along the beach. There are many seaside themes Funda loves to teach. So walking was our first word. Everybody, let's walk around your front room. Go! Walking. Walking fast. Fast walking. Walking. Pretending we're at the seaside. Splash. 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 Digging sandcastles. Digging sandcastles. Digging sandcastles. Swimming in the sea. Swimming in the sea. Now we're at the seaside. Close your eyes. Keep them closed. And you can hear all the seagulls in the air. The sun is shining down. And you've got a big ice cream. Give it a lick. Lick your ice cream. Awesome. And relax. We're at the seaside. Look, a crab, cries Funda. See it scuttle on the sand. If you can scurry like a crab, quick, put up your hand. Quick, put up your hand. So we've got scuttle. We've also got put up your hand. And we've got scurry. So I'm going to show you each of their movements right now. Here's scuttle. Let me show you scuttle. How we scuttle along the ground. Like this. We scuttle along the ground like a crab. So stand like this. Okay? And we're going to scuttle along the ground like a crab. Moving from side to side in your front room. You've got it. That's it. Put up your hand. Both hands. Reach up. Put up your hands. Awesome. Well done, everybody. That's fantastic. And we've got a crab. We've got Fun Dog, who likes to go woof woof. We've got Funda, who's cuddly and furry. And Fundette, who likes to cheer. Everyone puts a paw or hand really high into the sky. I can do the crab, says Fundette. Let me have a try. So you can see Fundette just doing the crab. And everybody put up their hand, okay? She flips over backwards. She hands and feet both on the ground. And like a crab, she shuffles, going sideways, round and around. Can you go round and around? Round and around? Can you scuttle like a crab? And when I say flip over, ooh, we flip over. And we flip over like this. And we flip over. And we flip over. Moving like a crab around your front room. Awesome, guys. Well done. Okay. And the next one, I'll find out where I put my story. Here goes. All the others have a go at sideways, skips and crawls. Look over this rock pool. A starfish, Funda calls. Look, a starfish. Funda sees the starfish and says, I can do that too. Funda stretches out his arms, but he has too few. Can you stretch out like a starfish? Stretch up high. Stand like a star. Really wide. Really wide. And stretch up your bodies. It's good to stretch. And say, I am really powerful. I am the best. I am active. I am great. I love Funda. And we smile. Let's move on to the next page. Here goes. The starfish has five, says Funda. But we'll try our best. Who can do the highest star jump? That will be the test. Who can do the highest star jump? That would be the test. I don't think you can do a star jump. I'll show you how. Are you ready? A star jump. Let me see if I can do a star jump. So we're here, we bring our hands in, we stand up straight. like this. And when I say go, we jump up high and reach out and land like a star. And shout, star, like the star you are. Back together, we're going to do five, because we have five fingers. Ready? Count with me. One, back in. Two, star jumps, back in. Three, star jumps, back in. Four, star jumps, back in. And five claps. Well done. Absolutely fantastic. In fact, fundatastic. Okay, here goes. Fun dog bounces in the air, his furry blue ears flapping, tail waggling. He's so high and everyone's clapping. Does your doggy jump up high? Ooh. Let's play in the waves. Fundara loves to make a splash. Fundu runs in with his ball to throw and kick and splash. So we're going to pretend that we're in the sea right now and we're going to splash. We're going to throw. We're going to kick and smash. So the first movement is going to be splash. Ready? I want you to jump up and splash the water. Jump up and splash the water. We jump up, splash the water. Okay? We kick. We kick our legs out. Kick our legs really high. Kick our legs faster. Well done. And the last one is throw. So we're going to pretend to throw a ball. Throw a frisbee. Throw a ball. Throw a frisbee. Throw a frisbee. Throw a frisbee. Throw a ball. Good. Bounce a ball. We're bouncing a ball now, look. Bouncing a ball. Okay, foot on the ball. Put your foot on the ball. Whoop. Good. Excellent. Well done. Funda and Fundude swim fast against the tide. Fundog dives and dodges, having fun at the seaside. Let's swim, guys. Swim. Faster. Breaststroke. Doggy paddle. Backstroke. Come on, faster, backstroke. Good, excellent. Ready. Uh-oh. Dirt. What do you think's in the water? Dirt. They play catch on the sandbank. They have a super race. Fundara runs off with the ball, and the others all give chase. They are having such a time, they fail to see the fin. As it glides on through the water, it quickly closes in. Oh, what do you think it is? What do you think it is? Oh, comment below what you think this is in the water. What do you think this is in the water? What do you think this is in the water? What do you think it is? What do you think it is in the water? I'll let you catch up. I'm sweating. It feels like I'm in water. Look, my head's sweating. And that's okay because we're getting active and moving. But literally feels like I've been for a swim in the sea. Okay, but what is it in the water? What do you see? Oh, Lily May loves the seaside, Blackpool and St. Anne's. Well done, Lily May. I think she also likes the remote game. She's got me on pause and fast forward now. Brilliant. So when daddy or mummy has a dirty beer or a glass of wine at weekend, your child can press pause so that you never get to drink that dirty beer or alcohol again. Okay? But the question is, what was in the water? What do you think it is? Let me see. We've had some questions. We've had some answers. Thanks, everybody, for taking part. What's in the water, guys? Come on. Who's going to answer first? Tell me. What is in the water? Tell me. Oh, let's see who gets it right in a minute. Shark! Fundara yells. There are jumps and shrieks and screams. Our friends quickly realise this shark's not all it seems. Funda bobs on over and lifts up the suspect's fin to find that it stretched an orange furry grin. It was Fundog. Look, Fundog was in the sea. Fundog, everybody gasps. Oh, Fundog, you're not a scary shark. He wiggles like a doggy, wiggles in the water with a fin on. Bow wow bark. That was mean, says Funda, making people worry. Now trot around to everyone just to say you're sorry. Because it's important when you've done something wrong to say sorry, isn't it? Fundog does just that. Then he shakes his wet coat dry like this, drenching all his friends. Oh, Fundog, they all cry. Excellent. What a fantastic story as Funda's trip to the seaside. I hope you enjoyed that story, guys. Getting active, learning, and having fun. Now, have we got any questions? Let me see who we've got live. Thanks, Clint. Thanks, everybody. Thanks so much for your children taking part. Send me your pictures. Comment below your pictures. Post them on our page, and I will give out for the star of the week who joins us Monday, Wednesday, and Friday with free resources. Tell another parent. Tell your friends. And that's it for now. Have a great day. Hope you had fun. See you soon. Goodbye. Thank you.